All right, let's go across to our guests for more on the story. Rajalakshmi Joshi, activist, is with us from Mumbai. Ravi Srivastav, political analyst, is also with us from Mumbai. Sarah Shah Haleem joins us from Kolkata. Sarah Shah Haleem, of this person.
Are you can always go for a CBI. Are one mother of the family can ask for a CBI inquiry.
And who has to do that? The state
inquiry.
Government has to approve that.
What is the problem in that?
The state government has to approve that, sir. Not the center. Not the center, it's the state government. Rajalakshmi Joshi wants to counter you on that. Rajalakshmi Joshi.
So presently,
just order a CBI probe. It's very simple. Says our guest over here. Would you like to? Do you agree with him?
Yeah. No, the fact is that there are many people who have seen him being hit by the rod, and he had to go and hide in a shop. He had to try to save his life, and the minute he reached home, he lost consciousness. Yeah, he must have fallen in the bathroom or wherever, but that was because of his injuries on his head. So just because he fell in the bathroom or he fell in the living room or wherever it may be, that doesn't discount the fact that he was hit on the head by 16 people. 16 people have been taken. 16 people have been accused of,
no,
of attacking him.
If you have got an evidence,
and how can you just say that? No, there has to be an investigation,
like,
definitely. But this has been taken up by a lot of publications. But just because maybe some mainstream media that you follow have not carried it, does not mean that it did not happen. And it does not mean that only
a number,
only
a number of a number of news outlets actually did carry it, Ravi Srivastav.
You, so it becomes a saffron terrorist. And I think 16 people from a minority community attack somebody.
Yes. Ravi Srivastav, is it not a fact? Ravi Srivastav, is it not a fact that the pro CAA procession or protest or whatever you choose to call it was attacked?
I'm not saying that was a right incident. That was a wrong incident. That was a heinous crime if he was killed or he was beaten. But what I'm saying, let there be inquiry for that. But here, no inquiry is needed. It is open and shut. The man is brandishing the gun and killing someone. It's in open. Why he is not called a terrorist?
Sir, let me ask you a simple question. Let me ask you a simple question. Two wrongs don't make a right. I firmly believe that. And if there is a wrong that has been done in Delhi and there's a wrong that has been done in Jharkhand, does not make either of them correct. But I think this is a very bizarre logic. We have unequivocally condemned every act of violence, whichever political party, whichever ideology that person may belong to. I will repeat here, Ravi Srivastav, is unacceptable. It is against the law. Anyone spreading hate, anyone spreading communism is wrong. But having said that, why we should have a different approach for what transpires in Jamia Nagar and a different approach for what transpires in Jharkhand completely eludes me.
If the victim is from a different community, then it is open and shut. Somebody is standing with a gun and point blank hitting someone. Nobody is disputing any of that. We are right now discussing what is transpired in Jharkhand.
I am not disputing your facts, Ravi Srivastav, but respond to this.
What action has been taken, Madhav?
Sir, the police is investigating it. It's 24 hours. Nothing. What do you want? The man is under arrest. What do you want to take place?
In 24 hours. We were just discussing how Nirbhaya's family has not got justice for 7 years.
And you want that he should be hanged in 24 hours. Is that what you want?
Families have to be cooperative.